Hello, it's Sissy from Just Kitty Photography Studio. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I do the transitions between two setups. So as you can see in this video, there's two setups ready. The left one was the previous setup I did. I've already done the photos. This one is the final image. Then I transit her into this second setup. So once you've picked up the baby from the previous setup, I don't undo the wraps. Leave the internal wrap inside there, and I bring another second layer just to wrap the baby wrap. To cover the inside layer. There's not much tricks, not many tricks to wrap to do this wrapping technique. All you need to do is to make sure the layers, every single layer, is stretched. It's a cheesecloth wrap. I love it. You don't have to make it perfect, but just to make sure it's all stretched up. You can see how I wrap them double layers, like you fold the layer in half and then wrap. Mum was helping me out at the background because in this session I didn't have an assistant. Just to wrap it around until it ends. Then bring her hands to fix her hands. I usually stack them on top of each other. It's a little tricky when the baby's awake. I like flat fingers. Okay, once I've done the wrapping, still the baby's awake, not too rushed, because I'm gonna put her on the half floor. So I'm making sure that her head is supported on something soft, so I put a receiving blanket underneath or a towel. But because the towel is quite low, I was gonna put a second beam underneath her to raise her head up. So I was getting Mom to bring me two beings. They are like halo shape. You can make it up with some cotton stuffing, or you can use pillows as well. Okay, then, oh, she dropped her dummy. By this time she's probably she's already been quite sleepy. So ready to put her down. My felt is the good size to wrap her, and it can create that cocoon shape. Now she's awake again. She opened her eyes. Just take your time slowly. Don't rush it. She's transiting into your sleep. She may be cranky, so it wasn't too rush. The detail is around her head. You wanna make sure the edge of the fluff looks soft and not stiff, you know, like it's like a natural shape. Okay, I wasn't because her bottom obviously is quite big. I wasn't gonna tuck everything underneath perfectly, so I didn't bother. I didn't try to fix that bottom end too much. I know it can be fixed in Photoshop. Okay, here are the final shots. Thanks guys for watching. I hope you guys have learned my transitional wrapping technique. If you like my videos, please subscribe or hit like. If you are interested, you can also go to my blog at the below link. I recently upgraded my floor backdrops and I put a tutorial articles on there. Okay, check it out. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.